Guess who's back? Back again. Ewan's back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back? 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 Whoa. Now, if you haven't turned off this video after that, then there's clearly something wrong with you, but I, you know what, I appreciate you even more now, because that was fucking terrible. But yes, I am back. I'm back from a crazy 3 weeks out in China, of all places. I was working at the 19th Asian Games in Hangzhou, China. I never thought at the beginning of a year that I'd be going to China. I didn't even think I'd ever be going to China in my life, so, you know, it was a great experience. I learned loads of stuff, and I'm sure the pictures will show what I've been up to now. And also, if you follow my Instagram, which you should, it's at iBlakeQuaid, links in the description, then you would have known what I've been up to. So today we are talking about the Misfits Prime Car that's coming in Manchester Arena this Saturday. Now, yes, I hear you. It's not boxing. It's not real boxing. It's terrible for boxing. I hear all of that. You know, I understand where the criticism comes from. And I definitely sometimes do think they really push it to the edge. I remember that fight between Boogie and Wings Redemption. And I'm a fan of Boogie anyway. I watched him in his Frank days. So, I mean, that was really pushing it to the max. What should be allowed in a boxing ring?
Holy shit, is someone going to die of a heart attack?
Actually, I didn't. It's entertainment. I really try and separate myself, pro boxing, real boxing, and this whole Misfits thing, just because it's so completely different. I mean, you literally had a Mexican guy who's no one even heard of, called Pineda, and now he's like some sort of, a year ago, and now he's some sort of cult hero in the UK. You wouldn't get that in any other fight organisation, you know? It's chaotic, but you know what, I'm here for it. But I do think boxing sometimes does lose an edge in the build-up sometimes. I saw the press conference between Denzel Bentley, I think, the British middleweight champion, and Nathan Heaney. Like Nathan Heaney in the press conference saying, you know, I want my kids to look up to him and stuff.
What do you think of him?
I think of him as I think myself, to be honest. I think he represents the sport of boxing really, really well. I think, yeah, that he just does the job he needs to do. And there's no silliness in between.
And, you know, I love that, but save that for after. Save that for after, because if there's no nastiness in there, then people won't buy it. You know, bad news sells. That's my personal opinion on the whole argument. Now let's actually get on to the fight. So starting with the main event, it is KSI versus Tommy Fury. Now KSI, he's huge, like he's like a cult figure in the UK, particularly in the past 10 years. I've been watching his videos since he did Try Not to Laugh with his mum or his dad. I think that was the first one I watched years and years ago. So to see his come up is during that time, whilst I was at school and stuff, is absolutely mental. And he's fighting Tommy Fury on the other hand, who's a brother of heavyweight champion Tyson Fury. It's just wild. I still can't even process that. Like they're fighting each other.
I mean, what is going on? Like, I think everyone's getting it twisted here. Just because the man's very, very big on social media and this and that, it's a fucking bum. In this boxing world, he is a bum.
Tommy Fury. Okay, you're the man that, you know, everyone fears, everyone thinks is going to destroy me.
You walk onto it all day, mate.
Let's see if my overhand reaches your fucking face.
Let's see. If he comes in swinging like a man who's drunk at the pub, it'll be over in round one.
But yes, they're the main event, and, you know, for me, all pressure on Tommy Fury, very similar to the Jake fight. Not a real boxer. That's one of him and John's favourite things to say as well. All the pressure's on him. I think JJ should do what Jake didn't do, and I just think he should just go for it from round one, because Jake, even though he actually did a lot better than I think I think a lot of people thought he would, and he actually looked like competitive in there at times against Tommy. Not obviously he got beat, but you know, it wasn't like he got knocked out in the first 10 seconds or something like that. You know, he did well to survive in there and stuff. But I think Jake Paul should have gone for it more, because there are definitely weaknesses, especially in Tommy's defence. But I think if KSI just gets on the front foot in the very first second, is in his face, makes him go on the back foot. Obviously, it's got to be educated pressure. He can't just be crazy, because otherwise he's just going to gas out towards the later rounds. Even though it's six, and I think that suits him better, still, crowds there, everyone's shouting, you know, all this stuff. Lights. I know he's used to it, but when you're fighting another guy who's also significantly bigger than you, you know, your gas tank, it will go down a little bit. I mean, I'll be honest, I want him to win just because I think it'd be, as well as a fan of him, I just think it'd be hilarious if he beat a boxer, a real fighter, you know, a YouTuber beating a Fury, you know. I think it'd be great. So much fun. So, and the co-main event, Logan Paul versus Dylan Danis. Now, you could dub this as the people's main event just because of the build-up for this has been, I mean, you just, wow. It's just been absolutely crazy. Every single day since this fight announced, pretty much, Dylan Danis has been posting photos of Logan Paul's fiance Nina Agdal, on Twitter every single day. Been lawsuits flying around from Logan's side towards him. Dylan saying, "Oh, I'm out," or whatever that tweet was the other day. And now he's actually in the UK. It looks like it's going to happen. But I mean, I'm not going to believe it till I see it after what happened in January. So I'm going to literally need to see him in that walk to the ring, and I need to wait for the ref to start the match. I need for the bell to ring before I'm like, yes, okay, this is actually happening, because I just do not trust that man. As entertaining as he can be, not in the best way sometimes, but he just needs to fight, man, because if he doesn't, you know, there's no hope that any other organization, MMA or boxing, will ever work with him again. So he needs to do this, even if he gets battered, which I think that could very well happen. I saw the other day, he still doesn't have a coach or something crazy like that, which is what he said before he fought KSI. He was like, yeah, I don't have a coach, he's not a real fighter, you know? Looks like, based on his photos, he's been bouncing from gym to gym, hasn't really had a settled camp. All we know is that he's good at jiu-jitsu, but he's fighting his first ever boxing fight, which is completely different. And it's against Logan Paul, who has experience. And Dylan hasn't fought in, what, like 5 years? This is his last fight in Bellator? You know, so for me, I'm thinking, he's chatting all this stuff now, but when he does that walk, the nerves, because he hasn't done it for so long, in front of a big crowd like that in the Manchester Arena, you know, it's, I don't know how that one's going to go. I think Logan should win comfortably just because of the experience, but that is the people's main event, and we're just going to see how it turns out. Other noticeable fights in the card, Slim versus Salt Papi. Salt Papi, actually a really good, naturally talented boxer. He's probably one of the best naturally gifted fighters on Misfits. Really good at counterpunching. Fighting against Slim, who I don't think is nowhere near as technical as Salt Papi. He's got long arms, he can hit hard. He's got a big frame for, I think it's 160 they're fighting at middleweight. Probably going to be a rematch for that fight, no matter how it goes. Just because both of them are two of the best fighters in Misfits. So, Dean the Great versus Waleed Sharks. These guys have been chatting for ages. So much shit since the first fight when Dean knocked them out. I've been complaining, oh, it should have happened earlier. And again, that should be a great fight. People obviously think Waleed's actually the better boxer, and he definitely showed parts that he is better than Dean. Especially he's got a great left hook. That'll be a good one. How could I forget King Kenny versus Anthony Taylor? Anthony Taylor, hilarious character. Fought again another former MMA fighter from Bellator. He's so funny. fighting wise, he's not amazing to watch. Does a lot of clinching. Just kind of a bit like a Klitschko kind of hit and then clinch kind of style. Which he kind of has to do because he's fighting up and weight for most of the time. And he's doing the same again against King Kenny, who absolutely destroyed that Winderson guy in the Kingpin tournament. rest in peace to Kingpin. And yeah, he absolutely smashed him way too easy. And obviously Anthony Taylor's huge step up in quality. But you know, Kenny's getting better. He's got a really good jab, a bit like Slim. He's got long limbs. He's very athletic. So that'll be another good one to watch. Obviously, Anthony Taylor beat Sol Pappy this year. But obviously, Kenny's quite a different fighter. Not so much a counterpuncher as Sol, even though he probably can. He can probably do it pretty well. Fantastic fights across the board if you're into this whole thing. I get some people aren't into it. But yeah, that'll be the end of it, guys. Thanks for watching the video. Make sure you like and subscribe. Like I said earlier, my Instagram. Make sure you follow my Instagram at iBlakeWayne down in the description down below. And also my Twitter as well. I post more regularly on that, to be honest with you. That'll be in the description. So yeah, make sure you follow all my socials. And yeah, can't wait for this Prime card on Saturday. And obviously next weekend. No, 2 weeks. In 2 weeks' time, got a huge UFC card that has had some big shakeups this week. So definitely going to be doing a video on that before that happens. And yeah, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you on the next one.